But I see it as a problem that is a local and state problem everywhere, just not in Missouri or Florida, it's in Texas. It's a race issue, it's a poverty issue. I see, every time I turn around, I see in the headlines a homeless person, or not necessarily in the headlines, but a homeless person getting killed. And there's bigger issues that underlie police brutality. I realize that. But I'm just trying to raise awareness. I see a problem with policy, and I can kind of see both sides, but being former military, when I was deployed in Iraq, we had stricter rules of engagement than we do on our own citizens, and I see that as a big problem. You know, what's a human life worth? And when people are killing kids on the streets, they're unarmed with their hands up, it's obviously a big problem. And I think it happens a lot more than it's in the limelight in the media, and I think we're just now kind of becoming more aware of the problem. And I don't think that all cops are bad. I'm not against cops. I know that there's very people on the force that have the best intentions and they want to protect and they want to serve, they want to be police officers. You know, but I do think that, you know, when something like this happens, it doesn't need to be brushed under the rug.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Military.
Yeah,
I was too.
Were you?
And this, in essence, is they've got military tactics going on here, so it's as if, do you agree that they're using, terms of engagement or rules of engagement here in Ferguson that are, we wouldn't use over?
I feel like they have military equipment, but they don't hold themselves. The force doesn't seem to have the same standards as the military does at war, as far as rules of engagement go and SOP or standard operating procedure. I'm not an expert on what those are for each individual police department, but it's obvious when a kid gets shot with his hands up that it's less restrictive than in Iraq when someone can have a weapon. And as long as they're not pointing it at you, or if they're walking away from you, you don't kill that person. You know, it's whenever when they pose a threat, when it's justified to defend yourself. And this kid was unarmed, and he had his hands up. He's on his knees, according to witnesses. He was kneeling. And this isn't the first case. You know, I have the suspicion that this happens a lot, not only in Missouri and Florida, but in Texas and all over the nation, where officers aren't being held accountable for their actions. And, you know, politics gets involved and gets really hairy because nobody wants the department to look bad. But, you know, there needs to be accountability. And I don't see that there is. There needs to be justice for the victims, and I don't see that either. My mother actually was in brutality. She was tased in the head while walking away in front of my little brother's house. She face planted on the concrete and had two black eyes, had to glue her nose, stitched a lip. Probably had a concussion, scrapes and bruises, and welts everywhere. Nobody should have to see their mother like that, especially if they're not doing anything wrong. And she's mentally ill. And I know that there's a problem with us expecting our police force to be able to handle mentally ill people. There's a bigger problem with us not taking care of our mentally ill. I know there's bigger problems, but, you know, right now I'm just trying to draw attention to the underlying fact that police departments aren't being held accountable. And officers themselves, individually, are not being held accountable for their actions. As a soldier, we were held accountable for our actions. And we were in the crosshairs every single day. It was just as dangerous, if not more. And, you know, we're here in America, in our own country, and we're killing our own citizens out of hate, racism, biasness, or whatever, and it's just not right.
Amen, sister. Thank you.
Yeah.